Well, it's almost as if I've had two lives. I guess I have. I've probably had more than two lives. There are days when I sit and think, or not think, but memory. And so there are times when that person, that woman, that girl, that child may be present. And I have love for her. I hold her. I tell her it's okay. You're under loving, caring adult supervision now. Something dramatic happened to a sibling. And I responded as a child the way children do, which is I didn't know what to make of what was going on. I didn't have anybody to talk to about how I felt. I just kept it to myself. I didn't, and it built. I started doing drugs and alcohol when I was a teenager, I guess about 17. It was very, very sad. In the African American community and in the larger American community, mental illness is, when I was growing up, there was something wrong with it. You're crazy, that word. Lots and lots of stigma. And the shame and the guilt of being an addict, of being something wrong with my brain. Now, I was always being mentally ill. Stigma affected me. It's like, I'm not crazy. It was very difficult.
We still have a long, long way to go in this country to overcome the kind of stigma that exists. Unlike heart disease or cancer or diabetes, which we do a lot of educating about, we don't do a lot of educating about mental illnesses. Despite the fact that America has this reputation for being a very advanced country when it comes to health care, we are not an advanced country when it comes to mental health care. There are other countries that are doing better. We have a very severe shortage of qualified mental health professionals in this country, too. We don't have enough psychiatrists, particularly in rural areas. We don't have enough psychologists. How do we respond to a person having chest pain? We send 911, the ambulance comes, and they take the person to the hospital. They comfort the person, and they quickly initiate care. But if someone is having a psychiatric crisis, that care is oftentimes not available. We send the police. Police are the ones who respond to 911 calls if they involve psychiatric crises. And the police may even want to help the person. They may take the person to the local emergency room, but what they find out is there's no psychiatric beds available for them. And so sometimes people spend 10 hours or even 10 days in an emergency room, and then they get sent home or back out to the streets again. After years of sort of focusing our mental health resources on crisis care, waiting until people have emergencies before we help them, we're now starting to realize that the earlier we can intervene, the better chance we have of preventing the really terrible things that happen to people when they are diagnosed and don't get help. So There's a lot of money now being invested in what we call first episode psychosis programs, intervening when a young person, 17, 18, starts experiencing symptoms, intervening very aggressively, involving their family, providing them with psychosocial supports, working with them to make sure that they can stay in college. Well, I mean, I think one of the most exciting things that I can remember is when this country passed health care reform, Obamacare, the Affordable Care Act. Very clear in that law that mental health and substance abuse treatment had to be part of the care that was available to people through health insurance marketplaces. And that was when we realized that finally mental health wasn't on the outside looking in, that there's growing recognition that the brain is part of the body and needs to be part of any comprehensive strategy to improve healthcare in America.
You do.
Today I am alive, I am working, I am healthy, I'm a productive person, and I'm a living example. Life.